when we first came up with the idea way back in 1992, then it had a sort of a magic ring to it. It's like, what? Buy Nothing Day? It seemed to go against all the norms and precepts of our consumer culture. I remember walking around with a button on my chest that said Buy Nothing Day, and people would just come up to me and say, what the hell is that? And then we noticed that suddenly it was happening in the UK. All of a sudden, they didn't call it Buy Nothing Day, they called it No Shop Day. But still, it was suddenly popping up in London and then Sydney, Australia. And within a few years, Buy Nothing Day was celebrated in 65 countries around the world. You know, we're consuming 5 times more than we did 50 years ago, but it's still not enough. And we still haven't got the guts to actually ask ourselves the question, well, how much is enough? Now I have a feeling that this Buy Nothing Day meme will have a resurgence, and people will wake up to the fact that, you know, that if we're going to have any kind of a future, then we, the rich 1 billion people on the planet, the rich 1/5 of humanity, you know, we basically have to sort of cut back on our consumption. We can't keep on consuming 3 times more than someone in China, or 10 times more than somebody in India, or 15 times more than somebody in Africa. It was like a taboo subject where, you know, can't imagine quite, you know, Biden talking about reducing America's consumption, or the Prime Minister of Canada, or Boris in the UK, you know, all of a sudden coming on board and admitting that overconsumption in their countries is something that we have to think about and possibly rein in.